Welcome to this lecture. In this lecture, we will going to working on library section with respect to user part. So go to Sublime and open library.php in learning folder, directly in learning, not into go to EP folder. So here, watch code from video. You can download this file, link is given in the video description, and paste it here simply. And now localhost hash slash learning, after that click on library and libraries here. So library user file, just delete this comment, php comment, save it. The idea is that whenever you click on computer science, the only computer science categories with the books which belongs to the category computer science from computer science display here. And when you select machine learning, books are not available yet in machine learning category. So the idea is, whenever you select all, the all books are shown here. So simply, if I go to library section, in library section, so I go to machine learning for machine learning basic concepts, and the category is machine learning, the book cover is simple and PDF, and description is ABC. Submit, and here is remember one point, go to the library which is in go to EP, and here is the code, script code, which is very interesting. It is for upload file, and it will show the status of the file. If I upload a file which is about 300 MBs online, in online, how I can wait and I can watch the status that the book is uploaded 50% or 30% or 10%. Now I am working on a local environment, local host, so this is useless. But while this website is on server, online server, it will be amazing feature that you can watch the status update, that how much file is uploaded, how much data is uploaded till now. So by using these lines, you can watch the status, the error, about, and these all. So AJAX will update the status. And now when I click on machine learning basic concepts here, and when I click on computer science, exceptional programming, programmers projects are here. So the key idea is that here is the section content, post content, and form. In form section, the only selection is select field is here, and in select field, ID is category option. And on change, if the value is changed, this button means if I change the value, now I change, there is no refresh. If I change the value, the page is refreshed. If I change the value, but if I don't want to change the value, here is no refresh or no change in the page. So here, if this dot value LEO is not equal to 0. It means not is equal to all. This form is subnet. So it means there is no change, no need to submit. If there is a change occur, then this form will submit. Option value is A for all. So the if form is submitted, then here post method options on change category option. If form is submitted and the category option, we stored the category option into the new category, and else the new option is empty. So you can here are the options that we are going to so basically first time when I click on library, so what happened? It contains all, including all the categories that is in your database. So first of all, retrieve all the categories. For this, select all from categories. It means that we are going to select all the categories and store into this selection box. And for this purpose, we can store these options. So first option is here. So here is the first option. First option is all and the value is A. And all other options are here. We are going to retrieve by using a while loop, and in while loop we are retrieving the new option is equal to ID is selected. So the if condition is that select the option where raw ID is equal to new option ID. For example, if I select this one, try to understand the computer science ID 1, the page is refreshed, the new option ID is here 1. So I want that because computer science is selected, so display the computer science in the selection box, and for that it means that select the field new option where new option is equal to the ID. So select the these are the two categories. I want to select the category which is selected by the user. So computer science is a new option which is 1, and 1 where the raw ID is equal to 1, select the option. So here now I have two options. So I want to retrieve a record with all the books or by category. So if I want to retrieve a record which is all, like if is option is not empty and new option is not equal to A, so I want to retrieve a record that according to the category. So select all from library where category ID is equal to new option. So the new option may be, when I ever click on machine learning, the new option is 2 or 3 where category ID is equal to 3. So select books and display book according to, and here you want to now we are in learning folder. So first go to EP here, then go to books, and then after that go to books, click on the you can here mention the book name and you can view the book. So simply whenever you click on download button, you go to here. So in this method, you can also view the book. Simply you are going to open the book like this method. It's different little bit that we already learn in admin section. So in this way, and if in this if condition, if this condition is false, or and what happened in else section? In else section, here is the cover, name, description, download, and select all from the library. If the value, here is the value all, in all option the value is A. If the value is A, then it will go to else part, and in else part we are just changing a little bit, just change the query, just delete this one, and just after deleting this one you can show the record. So if I select all, books are available from both categories. If I select computer science or machine learning, the books from only the one section. I hope it will be interesting for you and a little bit tricky. After that you can close the SQL connection, and if record is not found, you can count the number of rows. If rows are not greater than 0, it means there is no row in the result table. So in result table there is no row, so you can simply display the message, books are not available yet. So you can display the message. So in this way you can view the books. I hope this video is interesting for you. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel. See you in next lecture.